Ladies and gentlemen, Homies in Paris is the best Kanye song you still have not listened to. Kanye West, a man of many traits. He was this guy.
George Bush doesn't care about black
people. That guy.
I just told you who I thought I was, a god.
That
guy. I have decided in 2020 to run for president.
At one point he said this, I don't really know.
Yeah. George Luke.
Yeah.
Kiss.
Yeah.
He's the main character in Star Wars. He kissed his sister.
The year was 2007 when Kanye West dropped one of the most influential and world-renowned albums in human history, Graduation. Recognized as a 10 out of 10 album by many, Graduation is a household album in the hip-hop industry that nearly everyone knows or has at least heard of. And if you haven't... But what if I told you there is still more to this album? A secret Kanye song that went unreleased to majority of the world and is not on any streaming platform to date. Ladies and gentlemen, I had to dig through the depths of hell to find this relic, this gem, scouring the most heinous, most vile websites known to man to find this piece of auditory euphoria.
It's on YouTube.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bittersweet Poetry is the best Kanye song you still have not listened to, and you are surely missing out. This is a top 10 Kanye song, and even if you aren't a fan of Kanye or Ye, as a matter of fact, I'm essentially putting you on.
Yes, I am that annoying friend.
And if you're seriously thinking about clicking away from this video to listen to it yourself, don't.
That's a threat.
If it's your first time ever hearing about this song, then we'll listen to it together on this video, because I took it upon myself to give Bittersweet Poetry a very fitting
aesthetic music video,
given that it didn't have one. So stick around for that. But first, I need to give some background information. Gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die. Bittersweet Poetry was released as a bonus song in the last track for the exclusive Japanese version of Graduation. And let me tell you, there was some major gatekeeping from the Japanese for this song, and it really just flew under the radar for most of us. It was that good. I only ever heard of the song because I saw a YouTube short of Kanye West working with John Mayer on a song I'd never heard before. I was immediately hooked in by the beat. In one way or another, I found myself scouring the internet for the full song. I eventually found out that the only platform this song was on was YouTube, with videos that didn't even cross the 2 million views mark. So I decided to give it a listen, and let's just say, listening to it, my ears were immediately met with a cutesy, flowery type beat that made me reminiscent of the good old days. A beat that made me reminiscent of the glory and innocence that was old Kanye. But what was old Kanye? Well, old Kanye was a thing of the past. Well, I mean, obviously it's in the name. Basically, it's Kanye from all the I Miss the Old Kanye edits. If you know, you know.
I miss the old Kanye, straight from the Go Kanye.
Especially Hitler.
One thing about Mr. West is that his entire discography is made up of how he is feeling in the moment. Meaning I'm glad he didn't drop an album during this. I mean, you got high-spirited Kanye, go-getter Kanye, colorful Kanye, emotional Kanye, high and mighty Kanye, God complex Kanye, introspective Kanye, bipolar Kanye, and of course, Jesus Kanye. Oh, and this, Kanye 2024. Aww. Which is why Bittersweet Poetry is the best Kanye song. It managed to take a piece from every Kanye album. It took me back to the early ingenuity of Kanye's earlier works. A sense of nostalgia where things just seemed simpler, with everyone still dealing with their own individual problems. It managed to give us a glimpse of Kanye's emotional landscape, and this song was essentially a cesspool of fame, love, and self-awareness. Even with all the conflicting emotions, this song made me forget about all the current controversies Kanye is going through, and instead teleported me to a better place, a happier place. A more colorful place. John Mayer and Kanye West blended to create a blissful masterpiece with heartfelt lyrics, beautiful sampling, and an extremely catchy hook. I could envision the whole music video in my mind as I was listening to it. So, like I mentioned before, I took the liberty upon myself to make Bittersweet Poetry its very own music video, given that didn't have one. So, go grab a pair of headphones and enjoy Bittersweet Poetry for its bittersweet beauty.
Let me tell you a story. So this is around the time that it was that whole thing between him and 50, like who's gonna have the better first
week. Oh, yeah, right, yeah, yeah.
50's like up, you know, yeah, give us that shine is like classic. I mean, Kanye had a listening session, the local movie theater that was there. And what Kanye did is that he had programs and edited visuals from anime movies that he liked and played that in sync to the music. The moment that he did that, I was like, Kanye wins.
This bad, never did this before. That's what the virgin says. We've been generally warned. That's what the surgeon says. God talk to me now. This is an emergency. And she claims she only with me for the currency. You cut me deep, bitch. Cut me like surgery. And I was too proud to admit that it was hurting me. I never do that to you, at least purposely. We breaking up again. We making up again. But we don't love no more. I guess we fucking then. Have you ever felt you ever want to kill? And you mix them emotions with your killer. And you mix that with a little bad advice. Someone in them bad nights, you have a bad fight. And you talking about her family, her aunts and shit. And she say, motherfucker, your mama's a bitch. You know, domestic drama and shit. All the attitude, I never hit a girl, but I shake the shit out of you. But I'ma be the bigger man, big pimpin' like Jigga Man. Oh, I guess I figure it's
sweet.
What I want so much, she never hurt this bad. Never did this before, that's what the virgin says. We've been generally warned, that's what the surgeon says. God talk to me now, this is an emergency. And my nigga said I shouldn't let it worry me. I need to focus on the girls we getting currently. But I've been thinking and it got me back to sinking in. This relationship, it even got me back to drinking at this Hennessy. It's gonna be the death for me. And I always thought that you having my child was a destiny. But I can't even vibe with you sexually. Cause every time that I try, you will question me. Saying you fucking them girls, disrespecting me. You don't see how your lies is affecting me. You don't see how life was supposed to be. And I never let a nigga get that close to me. And you ain't cracked up to what you were supposed to be. You always gon', you always be where them hoes to be. And this the first time she ever spilled a soul to me. I fucked up and I know it, G. I guess it's bittersweet poetry.
I don't want you, but I need you. I love you and hate you at the very same time. Bittersweet. You're gonna be the devil for me. I don't want you, but I need you. I love you and hate you at the very same time.
See what I want so much, she never hurt this bad. Never did this before, that's what the virgin says. We've been generally warned, that's what the surgeon says. God talk to me now, this is an emergency. See what I want so much, she never hurt this bad. Never did this before, that's what the virgin says. We've been generally warned, that's what the surgeon says. God talk to me now, this is an emergency.
Bittersweet, you're gonna be the death for me. I don't want you, but I need you. I love you and hate you at the very same time.
Go listen to all my music. It's the codes of self-esteem. It's the codes of who you are. If you're a Kanye West fan, you're not a fan of me. You're a fan of yourself. You will believe in yourself. I'm just the espresso. I'm just a shot in the morning to get you going.